He arrived at the citizens' meeting to receive an address of welcome and a purse. In his first public speech outside the Indian subcontinent since 1914, he declared that India did not stand for isolated independence. One-fifth of the human race, becoming free through non-violence and truth, can be a great force of service to the whole of mankind. He extolled the simple way of life associated with the Khalifs and told the Arabs to help solve the Hindu-Muslim problem. As the ship was gliding through the Suez, messages of welcome from the Egyptians poured in. On crossing the Egyptian waters, Madame Zaghloul Pasha sent the great leader of Great India her best wishes for the success of the Indian cause. Gandhi had in his loyal secretary Mahadev Desai an assistant who not merely relieved him of much of his routine work, but put his keen intellect and tireless capacity for work at his disposal. Mahadev's devotion to Gandhi was complete, and Gandhi's affection for him deep and unbounded. On the misty, cold morning of September 11th, SS Rajputana anchored at Marseille. When the spiritual ambassador of India alighted on the soil of war-weary Europe, he was hailed with shouts of Vive la Gandhi. At Folkestone on September 12th, Britons gathered to greet the guest of the nation. Gandhi landed on British soil with thoughts of the hard task ahead. I am here to vindicate the honor of India and to uphold truth as I see it, for I believe it is the keystone of life. Gandhi had accepted Muriel Lester's invitation to stay at Kingsley Hall, a center dedicated to the slums of London. The members of every section of Bow assembled outside Kingsley Hall to welcome Gandhi. The pearly king, accompanied by his son and daughter, came to pay respects to the distinguished visitor in his domain. Gandhi greeted the costermonger royalties who offered him their best oranges.
Take the orange, yes. Thank you. Why take only one? I take two. Kill!
At the Federal Structure Committee of the Round Table Conference held at St. James's Palace, the voice of resurgent India spoke through Gandhi. The goal of absolute independence remains intact. Gandhi stressed the need of adult suffrage and racial equality and advocated an honorable partnership between India and Britain. The nation that does not control its defense forces and external policy, asserted Gandhi, is hardly a responsible nation. He struck a note of warning. A nation of 350 million people needs simply a will of its own to say no, and that nation is today learning to say no.